Today we're going to be looking at a broken play that Tyler Herro was able to turn into a positive play all by the use of his feet. And so this is going to be a little bit different than we normally would do in a breakdown, because we're going to be looking at an imperfect environment in terms of the ball handling in the hands and how footwork is able to adapt if your foundation is in place. So we're going to jump right into the play where Tyler Herro is driving full speed down the floor with contact on the inside shoulder. Now that contact is what causes the first disruption to his flow. I don't have that contact, but I'm still going to simulate the same type of stop. And so when I get to my stop, we're just going to work on stopping with a hand exchange. Now in Tyler's example, he starts to lose the ball there. What we're focusing on is just simply the ability to stop while exchanging the ball. And because if the defender is in risk of overplaying you, now the ball is already free or safe and protected. Now what we're going to do is start looking at the details of the play. As Tyler starts to bring the ball back out, he allows himself to dribble and he feels the defensive pressure. And this is where the footwork mat and our accountability of our feet really come into play. Because what he's able to do is get from this closed off position, and he's able to get right into a spin seal. Now a spin seal is your ability to completely swivel your feet and swivel your hips and get from one staggered position to another. Now we don't have to be very big and exaggerated with these movements. In this case, all he needs to be able to do is get an angle back to the baseline. And so as he does his spin seal, he just simply opens up. And so if I'm able to get to the gold and the blue, now I'm flattened off to the defender, now it opens up my ability to hand exchange and get towards the baseline. Now that's the spin seal. We want to make sure that we can hold ourselves accountable to that width that he's able to find himself in, because that width allows him to be explosive through contact. But the big keys are the fact that when he exchanges the ball with a dribble release, so he has the ability to let the ball go and go to get it with a swing exchange. Now as he starts to drive, this is what he would have wanted to do. That would be the rhythm of a spin seal. He would have done a spin seal, exchange, take that step, and then drive with that next step towards the basket. But as we see in this clip, he loses the ball, starts to get towards his shoulder. He cannot take that dribble. So what he does in that instance is does an inverted skip off of his outside leg. An inverted skip is not natural, it's not normal, but the fact that you're able to do it in the moment is what's key. So he's able to go from that closed off position, do his spin seal, start to turn, feel that foot on the floor, knowing that he can't dribble, skip off of the outside leg to get right into that shot. It's the ability of Tyler Herro to have poised footwork, quality footwork, when he has a broken handle play that makes all the difference. So all we're doing right now is looking within the moments at this play and asking ourselves, can we pull off the same footwork? Now, when you train on your own, you don't have to be sloppy with your feet. But what we find in the process is this inverted skip and your ability to get right into that action, getting right to your shot, is actually a viable option that's perfectly legal as the ball's in a float position. If I'm legal to take this dribble after that step, then it's legal for me to pick it up. So that's the play within the moments with Tyler Herro, our ability to have great footwork despite what's happening with the dribble.